town, also our Fountain of Youth way down there at the end of the block. Another stop we make heading out of town. Right now, though, we're headed into town and we're headed back in town. We're going to start off in the year 1493. That's when Columbus was making his second of four voyages to the New World. On board, he had a young sailor by the name of Don Juan Ponce de Leon. Ponce de Leon ended up settling on the island of Puerto Rico. Once he became the governor of Puerto Rico, it's a whole other chapter. Now, St. Augustine was founded as the safe port for Spanish galleons coming up from Central and South America. They stopped here and resupplied before heading a little bit further up the coast, catching the newly discovered trade winds back across the Atlantic, Central and South America, back here to Florida. Mission grounds. They're going to be running through tonight, and then they're going to be moving on out here. All right, now our first stop we're here in town is going to be up here at the plumbing issues at that point. Gordon's built this house in 1887 known as Gordon's Castle. Around 1930, they were trying to sell the house. That was during the Great Depression. They were unable to sell it, so they just abandoned the house. It sat empty here through the 1930s. Local homeless would move in. City had to keep chasing them off. Around 1940, the city was making plans to tear this place down. That's when it was finally purchased by Marjorie Keenan Rawlings and her husband, Norton Baskin. Marjorie Keenan Rawlings was a Pulitzer Prize-winning author. She wrote The Yearling and Cross Creek. Norton Baskin, he ran hotels. He bought this place and he turned this into a hotel. Put more bathrooms in, of course. Now, during the 1940s, this was the place to stay here in town. Robert Ripley would often stay here. He was a cartoonist. Wrote the Ripley's Believe It or Not cartoon. He was in negotiations about this place. Before he bought it, though, he bought the farm. Dropped dead of a heart attack. In 1953, his estate had finally purchased it and opened it as the very first Ripley's Believe It or Not. And it's our stop for Ripley's Believe It or Not. Believe it or not. Lived in that thing for 26 years. After that, it went on a tour around the country, finally ended up here in our Ripley's parking lot. I was walking right through that thing, check it out, really neat, the original tiny house right there. It's about 600 square feet.
6,000 square feet.
Over here to the right behind the Modesty Hedge, you can see that statue of David peeking out there. That is an exact copy of the original statue of David in Florence, Italy, in every detail. Now, if you know anything about the statue of David, you can probably figure out why he's behind the hedge. Yeah, the city was getting complaints about the man in his birthday suit out in our parking lot, made us cover David up. Now, they do clean David every night with Windex to keep him from streaking. Wah-wah. You guys remember the Ripley's Believe It or Not TV show with Jack Palance? That was recorded right here in our parking lot, right underneath the awning over there. Later on, Dean Cain did some of those, so did Holly Palance, Jack Palance's daughter. That is back on the air now. Making the sun for about a year, that stuff was hard to kind of break. Lots of structures here in town are made of coquina. I'll be pointing some more to that all the way. There's our visitors information center. Originally built in 1935 as a dance hall gathering hall in St. Augustine. Over here, right, is our Huguenot Cemetery. Huguenots were French Protestants. Back in the early days, if you weren't a Catholic, you weren't allowed to be buried inside the city wall. You can see this cemetery is located just outside the northern wall of the city. This wall was called the Kubo Line. The Kubo Line ran from the fort there through the city gates. Right down here to Cordova Street, where our Potter's Wax Museum is nowadays. That's where it ran into the Rosario Line. I was the U.S. here, but it's all the city. Also, we're here to make those wax rig is right in front of me. See how he looks? These guys are real artists. Amazing work they do there. Next time we're going to be St. George Street, just the side of the city gates. St. George Street's a great place to go to get a bite to eat, do some shopping, pick up some souvenirs. You can also check out some of the museums they have over here on St. George Street. One of the museums is the oldest wooden schoolhouse in the nation. You'll see the old wooden schoolhouse just down here on the right about 100 feet from our stop here. And this will be our stop for North St. George Street. Good evening, folks. Welcome aboard. My name is Rod. How you guys doing? All right. You guys in the back there, you're right. The Castillo de San Marcos, the Castle of St. Marks, or as we call it, the port. The port there was also built with coquina. We'll make a stop right there in the port parking lot on our way out of town. This is the 10th fort to be built here in the year. The first time we made of wood. Didn't last very long. Termites would get through a lot of fire, even by enemy armies. Haven't learned since the best time. Here. 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 That is the Anastasia Island. That is where they got all the coquina bridge built here in town. Only a couple spots before we find coquina here. Far as one, the other is in Puerto Rico. Now, if you look way out there to the left, you see the inlet for the bay out there. You see the Atlantic Ocean. After you leave that inlet, there's nothing but Atlantic Ocean all the way to North Africa. Back there, said, are there really sharks out there? Well, it's the Atlantic Ocean. Yeah, there's millions of sharks. See, our lighthouse just past the end of the bridge over there. It's the second lighthouse to be built out there. The first one fell in 2 years in 1870. That was completed in 1874. And they built that first one a little too close to the beach there. Now, the big cannons at the fort could shoot 3 miles and could hit that lighthouse last time if they wanted.
Oh, yeah.
Of course, they never shot at the lighthouse. All right, we're heading down Hypolita Street. Things you notice about a pile of yours is pretty narrow. It's not a straight line. It's nearer north of the channel there to the city. Spanish garden. Look right in the center of the garden there, a little statue that is Queen Isabella on her burrow. She's the one who financed Columbus's trips to the New World. I made her the original undercover boss. Think about it, she didn't like what you had to say. She had to be locked up or worse. All right, across the St. George Street here, you go to the right, right into your city gates. Go to the left, right into our plaza down there.
Sorry.
Hitler came down. Down here from Ohio, he fell in love with this area. He wanted to build some hotels here. He was an oil company executive, part of Standard Oil Group. He wanted to build some hotels here. Now, one of the spots where he wanted to build his first hotel was an old bed. If you guys will donate your land to me, I'll donate some land right down the block. Go to you guys a brand new church for free. Now, of course, they said yes. When I make my turn here, that church is going to be right in front of us. That's going to be the Grace United Methodist Church. Now that beautiful church is made with poured concrete construction. They use red terracotta. Doors here are solid oak. Weighing hundreds of pounds of piece here. Hand carved. Look, these archways over the entryway there. Hand carved terracotta, quarter from Italy. Also the bell tower there is amazing. Yeah, there's a bell tower up there. There's no bell up there, though. When they will hoist the bell up, up there. I guess that made him a dead ringer. After that, they said, let's just forget about the bell here. When the Baptists saw that church, they got a little jealous and said, hey, Mr. Blacker, how about building us a church? By that time, as we've been working on other projects, they said, I'll tell you what, I'll donate some land, I'll donate half the money, you guys come up with the other half. Up here on the right, see that beautiful yellow brick church there on the corner of this ancient city of Baptist Church. Those bricks are called sulfur bricks. High sulfur content give them a natural yellow color. Flagler was a Presbyterian, son of a Presbyterian minister. And there, right, you see the Flagler Memorial Presbyterian Church. My favorite building here in town, one of the most beautiful churches in the world. He had a daughter. His daughter's name was Jim Louise. He loved her more than anything in the world. He found out she was having his first grandchild. He was elated. Unfortunately, there were complications during childbirth. She soon passed away and so did the baby. He wanted this building built within 1 year of her death, so he could open on that anniversary. He hired 1,000 men. They worked around the clock 360 days later, and his church is ready to be occupied. This building is also made with poured concrete construction. They use yellow terracotta for the ornamentation. The dome up there is copper, 120 feet tall. Now, during the weekdays, there's a free tour of the church every day but Sunday. They have their services on Sunday, then they are closed for the day. You can check out the grounds over here at any time. Beautiful, awesome. Some of those amazing stained glass windows up there. Henry Flagler, his first wife, his daughter, Jen Louise, granddaughter, all buried inside that church there. A little mausoleum in there for him. Daughter's holding her baby in her arms. Flagler College, that was Henry Flagler's first hotel he built. This was his flagship hotel here in Florida. He had hotels all the way down the east coast of Florida, also on the East Coast Railroad. That's how he get his guests down here. This building had something very unique today called electricity, right here where the Molly Wiley Art Building is. That housed 4 engine coal-fired generators. This building had electricity 4 years before the White House in Washington, D.C. One of the first buildings in the world to have electricity incorporated into its original design. Back then, people were afraid of electricity, thinking they were going to get shocked. Of course, they also thought it took years off your life if you messed around with light switches. So he had to hire men called switchers to turn light switches on and off for his guests. Their job was to stand in the hallway, wait for a guest to signal, go down, turn a light switch on, or turn a light switch off. They got paid 75 cents a day for switching light switches, which was pretty good money back then. Back then, a Pennsylvania coal miner got paid about 65 cents a day. I was a coal miner that came on down here to Florida, got me a job switching light switches. Being a tour train driver, that sounds like a good job. He was also good friends with Lewis Comfort Tiffany. Over here to the right, see that round, of course, building there? All those windows there are Tiffany stained glass windows. That is the largest collection of Tiffany stained glass windows in its original location in the world. Tiffany was an interior designer, did a lot of interior design work in this building. Also lots of beautiful artwork in there, sculptures, wood carving, tile work, paintings. The students give a tour of that building every day at 10 and 2 o'clock and check out those windows up close and all the other beautiful artwork they have inside there. Nowadays there are about 2,500 students to go here, but this is a liberal arts college. Funny looking chains in between the posts there called harbor chains. Those are replicas of the original harbor chains, would have been the entrance of the harbor. Original chains would have been much larger. Yeah, when enemy ships would come into view, they pull those chains up just below the water lines. The chains would drag at the hulls of the wooden ships, hopefully tear them open and sink them. Usually just slow them down. The main entrance for the college. You can see some of the beautiful artwork around the top of the archway there. Just a sample of some of the stuff you see inside. Love these lion's heads on the pillars out there. Aren't they cool? That statue right there is Henry Flagler's. He looked at 54 years old. And they say he hated that statue. They didn't put that up there until 1913 when he died at the age of 83. Now that building's also made with poured concrete construction. So is this next one over here, the Villas Arena. It's one of the first buildings in the world to be built like this, built by Franklin Smith as his winter home. He helped to develop that technique of building. Looks like a layer cake, doesn't it? They put down a form, four layer of concrete, and that layer got hard, they didn't form up for another layer, and another, just keep going until they got their desired height. These walls are almost a foot thick, made of solid concrete and reinforced with old railroad rails, didn't have rebar back then. These days, this building is an antique museum. A 10th scale replica of the west wing of the Alhambra Castle in Granada, Spain. Franklin Smith loved that castle, visited it when he was in Spain. He took some pictures, made this one on the bill here. Now, back in the 1930s, that building was a speakeasy. It was also a casino at one time. When Henry Flagler built his Ponce de Leon Hotel, it was a beautiful hotel. Lots of amazing things to see in there. Nothing to do though, so right across the street he also built the Alcazar Hotel, which is now the Leitner Museum. The Alcazar over here had all the amenities. Had a Swedish bath, a Turkish bath, had the world's largest indoor swimming pool today. That pool had a retractable roof. Also had a bowling alley, a silent movie theater. Out back they had a shooting range, archery range, tennis courts, a bicycle academy. He also had a 9-hole golf course nearby. Lots of stuff to do here at the Alcazar. In 1948, this building was purchased by Otto Leitner. He was the editor and publisher of Hobbies magazine. Also went around collecting people's collections. We saw a collection of stamps, collection of coins. Collection just about anything he liked. He purchased it from me, put them on display right here in his own personal museum. When he died, he was also put on display. He is buried right up there in the courtyard. He left this building to the city of San Augustine. This is now the town hall, the city office, and also still the Leitner Museum.
Oh, yeah.
Also, a lot of player pianos in there, old Vitrolas every day at 11 and 2. They fire those mechanical things up and show you how they work.
say yes, but are you, do you want to come?
That statue up here is Pedro Menendez. He's the man who founded St. Augustine. That was sent to us by his hometown of Avalis, Spain. His official title would have been Don Pedro Menendez de Avalis. Now somebody asked him one day why Pedro was wearing a neck brace. He said, no, it's part of the uniform. Actually, it's part of the armor.
You got a picture from this exact spot, right?
All right, this beer stop. Be hot and cold running water. They had Wi-Fi and air conditioning back then. It would be all set today, right? Buildings were designed by Hastings and Carrera. They were going to design the New York Public Library. But in the late 1880s, early 1890s, there was state-of-the-art back then. In those days, men and women weren't permitted to swim together. There's a partition down the center of the pool to keep them separated. Men walk around shallow in the pool, smoking cigars, talking about business and politics. Slaves after the Civil War in 1866, the name for Abraham Lincoln. At one time, there were over 400 Victorian homes in the area. Still about 200 of those homes remain today. Largest collection of Victorian homes in Northeast Florida. These colorful Victorian homes are called the Painted Ladies. See this grave one over here on the right? That's when they're just starting to restore down. And there's a pretty rough shape still. There are ways to go with that one. Come back next year, though. That one there might look like this grave one over here. This house here was also the home of Thomas Jefferson's great-granddaughter when she lived here in town. Now, if you buy a house here in Lincolnville, you want to restore it, you have to use the original type materials they used when they built these houses to restore them. No vinyl siding, anything like that. These homes should be really strict about what folks think of these houses here. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Avenue.
The Victorian houses were always done in three colors.
When Dr. King was in town, they had to move him from house to house every night. There were a lot of death threats against him. He was assassinated only 4 years later. Down here on the right, you can see a white house with red trim. This is one of the houses Dr. King stayed in when he was here in town. This house is part of the Freedom Trail. You see the Freedom Trail marker here in the front yard? Over here, this is Dr. Haley's dental office, now a civil rights museum, also part of the Freedom Trail. And those Freedom Trail markers are all over the city here. You can pick up a map at the Visitors Information Center, download an app on your phone, do your own walking or driving. Get fish. So the spider monkeys are the least of our worries. See our Casa Monica Hotel over here, right? That was Henry Flagler's third hotel he had here. He didn't build that one, no, that was built by Franklin Smith, the man who built the Villa Zareta over there. Franklin Smith was having a hard time getting people in this hotel. Just too much competition for him here, he's going bankrupt. Before he went bankrupt, though, his friend Henry Flagler stepped in, offered him 9 cents on the dollar, and purchased his third hotel here. Now this is the only hotel he had in town that's still a hotel today, and it's the only 4-star hotel we have here in town. And one of the only locations where you can get yourself a Starbucks coffee. Spain had possession of Florida as the capital of this part of Florida. That is the governor's house. That's where the governor lived. Back then, every Spanish town had a central plaza. They'd have a governor's house in one end, a public market in the other, all the streets lead out from the center. Okay, this is our Plaza de la Constitución, the Plaza of the Constitution. Next house.
behind you.
He stops after you.
Oh no.
Alright, we're heading down to the place, Steve, every cathedral is located down here, right? That is the oldest Catholic diocese in the nation. There are death and birth records in the church up here dating back to the 1600s. That statue up there in the front of the church looking down and blessing us as we go by, that is St. Augustine. This balcony up here on the end of the governor's house, known as the Balcony of Kings, back in 1965 on a 400th anniversary. It's been known as the Balcony of Kings ever since. Up here for the 2015 celebration, the plaza shut down, the Bay Farm shut down. And a big stage set up at the other end of the plaza. I saw Amy Lou Harris down there. Good times. She was on a great show. Street over here on the right. They were doing some digging up here on Charlotte Street not too long ago. Dug up 27 bodies right up there in the middle of the street. When they do any digging here in town, they have to call the archaeologists in to sift through the dirt and digging up, make sure they're not digging up any artifacts or bodies. When they do find a body, they catalog where they found it, and if it's at all possible, they put those bodies right back where they found them. So those bodies over there in the street, still right over there in the street. Almost 5,000 years of human history in this part of Florida with the Indians, the Europeans, the Americans. There are three graveyards here in town. One of those is a military graveyard, the other two are really small. So where are all the bodies? They're everywhere. People got bodies out here in the bay. It's in Kansas Bay now, but Kansas in English means slaughter or massacre. As Pedro Menendez said here, he was told not only to start a settlement, also to get rid of the British and French soldiers that were in the area. He rounded the French up at Fort Caroline, just north of us where Jacksonville is now, when he got back down here. Found over 200 French soldiers shipwrecked along the beach just to the south of us after a bad storm. He brought those men back here, but they wouldn't declare Catholicism as their faith or claim their allegiance to the King of Spain. He had those men put to the sword. Nice way of saying he had them killed. 214 men and all he had killed. Their bodies stoned in the bay. It was said the bay ran red with blood for 3 days. I've got to leave our bay there. Matanzas Bay. Massacre Bay. Our next house is going to be up here at the oldest house. Now we noticed the oldest house because of all the signs on it. You got that one on the ground there, that one there, that one there, that one there. All say oldest house. Somebody asked me one day, which one is the oldest sign? I was like, well, we got me there, I'm not sure. In 1702, Colonel James Moore came down here from North Carolina. He was a British colonel. His plans were to take St. Augustine. He had counted on the newly built Castillo de San Marcos for him. After a 52-day siege, he was unable to take the fort. He was running out of supplies. The Spanish navy was close. He was forced to retreat and march all the way back to North Carolina to defeat. Before he left St. Augustine, he left us a present of Mississippi to rebuild, because he burned this one to the ground. Get in treaties. In 1760, the British captured Cuba. Spain wanted Cuba more than they wanted Florida, so they traded. The British had possession of Florida through the American Revolution. Finally gave it back to Spain in 1783. Second level of these homes here put there by the British. The Spanish built on one level. You see a two or three room bedroom house, or three room house with a garden entryway. The British wanted more rooms. They put the staircases in and put the upper levels on these homes. We're here right in the St. Francis Barracks. When the British took possession of Florida, that was the Franciscan Priory, a monastery. Just big here. All right, look way out there, right? You see the lighthouse out there. That thing's about a mile out from here. There are 219 steps atop our lighthouse out there. You see for almost 20 miles in every direction from a clear day. Hey, if you guys ever want to try for the record, you can. Get from the ground to the deck on top, 290 steps up in 56 seconds, you'll have the record.
Lighthouse.
See our old Santa Maria restaurant over here on the right. Things are pretty rough shape. Hurricane Irma came through here a few years ago, and Hurricane Matthew, the year before that, water's coming right over the crate, though. Through that place there, over the seawall and into town. They're going to be tearing that building down there, all the way to the next building. Probably make it a little bit higher next time. Yeah, it was almost bought by OC Lakes over here on the left, the seafood restaurant there. Our next stop's going to be our marina stop. You can take a cruise around the harbor on one of our harbor cruise boats back there. Also play 18 holes of golf here in Florida's oldest miniature golf course. And if you're a red train ride, you can pick it up for free right now. And this will be our stop. Over here right to see our bridge of lines. Got people climbing on the lines over there.
This is
the island! It's named after the two lines right there at the base of the bridge, of course. Purchased by Dr. Andrew Ames, one of our mayors back in 1930s. He went to Italy, purchased those lines, brought them back here, paid up the place of theirs, but known as the Bridge of Lines ever since. Those lines there were quarried from the same rock as the original Statue of David and the Statue of David we have in our Ruby's parking lot. All made from Carrera Mall.
Marco!
Babe!
Next stop is going to be up here at the Castillo de San Marcos. Castle of St. Mark, as we call it, the fort.
Argo!
Hold on.
Argo! Argo! Argo!
Our fort here was also built with coquina, almost a half a million blocks of coquina when they searched in the fort. The fort took 23 years to build, it was finished in 1695. As you look at the fort there, you're only looking at about two-thirds of it. The other third's buried in a dry moat. That moat came in handy when the city was attacked and people went inside for protection. Put some of their livestock and other goods inside the dry moat around the fort to keep that stuff safe. This entire area here is protected under the Antiquities Act. There's believed to be between 700 and 1,000 British soldiers buried out here in these fields, which extends into the parking lot here, into the city, all the way up north. There are dead bodies everywhere out here. After that battle with Colonel Moore in 1702, the Spanish came out of the fort. There were dead 9 British soldiers everywhere out there. They dug trenches 18 to 24 inches deep, just threw their bodies into them and covered with dirt. Had no respect for the British soldiers whatsoever. Average age of a British soldier back then was between 14 and 17 years old, just children. Therefore, those bodies buried then is where they lie today. They haven't moved any of those bodies. Thank you. All right, we're heading out of town back to the north. Passing our city gates over here. One time they were going to tear down our city gates. The local women's group got together, came down on top of us, taking our city gates. I think there's Lady Smith. Good job. You ain't got apparently, old car bumpers. Cars had chrome bumpers. That horse sat outside of Denver Stadium when they lost. See our statue of David back there behind the modesty edge. You guys want to check that out? It'll be gone tomorrow. We're moving out tomorrow. I think he's looking all right for 650 years old, though. 600. Now, the name of our tree here is the Old Senator. They call him the Old Senator because he's old, he's crooked, and he's shady. Tree's the Old Senator. There's a guy back there pointing his friend. Look at my friend here. He's an old senator. I said, you will not, you know what? He'll probably love my joke here in the middle of the street. Yeah, she was in her gown. He was in his tuxedo, and I was on a train in the background for a couple of them. That's kind of fun. Yeah, these sea breezes bend these trees over to give this tree the canopy effect. Spanish moss hanging down, give it kind of an eerie effect. This wall over here is called tabby, or tabby, made of horseshoe shells, sand, lime, and water. They use walls like that for fortification. The shells there are really sharp, have a lot of bacteria in them. Back in the early days, you try to climb a wall like that, get a cut from one of those shells. If you got infected, you'd be in big trouble with antibiotics back then. All right, this is the Fountain of Youth over here. It is closed now, so I'm going to be bypassing that, getting to the old jail. I've tried that Fountain of Youth water. I don't know if it works or not. I've been drinking it for 110 years, and I just keep getting older. I tried rubbing some on top of my head here, but that situation I got going on up there, it didn't work, but not yet. I'll keep trying. Building churches, building himself a home. They figured if Dave and Paper and Jan would be moved, he probably would. Of course, he did have the jail here, moved about a mile outside of town. He donated the land, had the building built. It was built by the Poly Company. That's the same people who built the Alcatraz Island prison. That red building directly in front of us up there, that's the bars on the left. That's the of course, that long right is the Lord's Quarters. That was such a pretty building. Back in the early days, people often stop here on the way into town thinking this was a hotel trying to check in. Just explain to them how to check into the jail. Of course, they changed their mind. All right, this is where I stop for the old jail. Oh, thank you very much, sir. Appreciate that. That's my parties nowadays. Go home and take a nap. All right, again, my name is Rod. I hope you guys enjoyed the tour.
Want to try golf?
All right, thanks for riding with us today, folks. I hope you guys did have a great time today. Can you come back?
Look at him. Oh, Santo. Perfect. Popcorn. You want to put out your hands for me?
I hope this one
falls out. Oh, yeah, not most of it.
Okay, I can try.
Because
I have a feeling it'll be closed
when we leave.
This is a nice house.
Casa de Hidalgo.
Where's he now? This in?
Out of blood?
Oh,
yeah. Sorry.
I can just go to the end of the street. So.
Koja je bila palisadna ograda i onda se tamo vidi kastelje Sankt Marko. Se nalazi u zalivu. Mnogo lep zaliv. Ovdje je glavna ulica. St. George Street. I malo pored je najstarija škola drvena na cijelom kontinentu. Ima jedno veliko sidro, kako ovo da ne bi odletelo.
Smešta. Evo je.
Ovdje piše The oldest wooden schoolhouse in the United States. Da. Cijela ulica je ovako, malo podsjeća na Mediteran. Utvrđava. Živa muzika, zalazak sunca, Tamo dole malo živi. Ćao, bebo. A ovo su od školjkica. Peto. Ej. Oh yeah, Ray-Ban.
Yeah.
ide de San Marco.
No worries, you're fine.
Thank you. Trilo stvrđevi, ovo je već glasija, ovaj oddeo, ovaj nasip. Eno tamo je usečen za ulaz. Nešto slično kao na Kalimunda, samo što je ovo naravno manjih dimenzija. Evo ga u se poglasio. Utvrđava je sad zatvorena, ali ovaj ovdje deo je, što se vidi, to je ravelin. A ovo su ovdje fase ugaonih bastiona. I naravno kapija se nalazi sa pokretnim mostom. A, evo. Znači kao kaleš samo umanjeno. Znači ovo je ovdje kapija Ravelina. Kao što kod nas imamo na primjer Stambol kapiju 2 ili Karadžićevu kapiju. I onda dolazimo na Ravelin. I onda sa njega prelazimo ovaj most pokretni. Sa bočne strane su ovaj flanke, odnosno unakrsna vatra. I onda je to ulazak u tvrđavu. Možemo da se prošetamo glasijom koja gleda na zaliv. Vjerojatno je ovaj deo nekada bio zagrađen. Nije moglo se uđe odmah tamo. Ovo smo u rovu tvrđave. Zalazak sunca. Blok je urađen od kokine, znači to je vrsta veštačkog betona koji se radi od delova školjki, tako da se vide delići školjki. Još jedan mali ravelin. Da, tako je.
That's thoughtful, thank you.
Let's see. Oh, just like she said, let me turn on the light.
I can do that. I can do that, but it's going to be your silhouette. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Yeah, this is good, this is good. I got some cloud in here.
Thank you.
Which way are we going? This way? This way? No.
Let's get out.